Hello students, let's discuss about reproductive health. We are proceeding with chapter number 8, how do organisms reproduce. So what are the major concerns here with reproductive health? First concern is how to stop the transmission of sexually transmitted diseases or STDs like syphilis, gonorrhea, HIV, AIDS or warts. Syphilis and gonorrhea are the bacterial diseases, HIV, AIDS or the warts are the viral diseases. So we should know how to protect ourselves from the STDs. Then the next concern is health and hygiene. So along with our normal or general health, the health of our reproductive organs and hygiene is a major concern. Especially the females should get hygienic conditions and they should get the sanitary pads for their menstrual phase of menstrual cycle. So this is also a major concern. Then the third concern here is birth control measures or the contraceptive measures. Let's proceed with the birth control measures first. What are the methods of birth control measures? Chemical method, barrier method, intrauterine device method and surgical method. Let's take them one by one. First, chemical method. So oral pills like Meri Saheli, IPL 72, etc. or so many other such pills are available in the market which contain combination of various female hormones like progesterone and estrogen or progesterone hormone, and these stop ovulation in the females. So this is one method. Second method is barrier method. So a kind of barrier is produced between male and female. How the condoms are used? So condoms for the males and condoms are the females. So condoms are males are used as a covering over the penis. So when the semen is released or discharged, it remains here within the condom. It will not go into the female tract. Similarly, condoms for the female, these can be used inside the vaginal tract of the females. Let's have a look at the diagram so that we can come to know how these are used. See, this is female reproductive system and this is the vaginal tract, and diaphragm is fixed here. So temporarily this diaphragm is fixed here and the penis of the male comes here, and the semen which is discharged from the penis will be released here. It will remain here only, and after the sexual act this diaphragm is removed and the semen will also removed from the body. So the semen will not go inside. So there is no chance of fertilization. So this is one of the method of contraception. Let's proceed with the next method, intrauterine device, copper T. So copper T is implanted inside the uterus of the female. How it is implanted? Let's have a look at this diagram. This is the diagram of female reproductive system, and we can see here that inside the uterus this copper T is implanted. It will help to avoid pregnancy for three years or 5 years. Of course, it is a temporary method, but it can cause irritation to the female, and some side effects are always there. Then we come to the next method, that is surgical method. In case of the males, vasectomy is done. What is done here? The vas deferens is cut and folded and tied so that the sperms do not move out. So there is no chance of fertilization. In females, tubectomy is done. Fallopian tube is cut from here, it is folded and then it is tied here. So the male and the female gametes cannot fertilize here in the fallopian tubes. So this is how tubectomy help in birth control measure in case of the human females. Then we come to the terms like population size. So the number of individuals inhabiting a particular area is known as population size. Several things influence the population size, like birth rate, death rate, infant mortality rate. All these things determine a population size, and as the population size keeps on increasing, resources keep on depleting. But when this population size exceeds beyond the limits and resources become meager for the population, and then it is known as population explosion, and the Indian population is just on the verge of population explosion. Then another term, female male sex ratio. So it is about how many females are there per 1000 males. Naturally it should be 50-50%. So after every 1000 males there should be 1000 females, but a malpractice which is known as female feticide is there. which disturb this female male sex ratio, and sex determination is done before the birth of the child, and if the fetus is found to be female fetus, then it is aborted. So this is a malpractice which must be stopped. Let us discuss about barrier method once again. As these condoms for males and females, they help to control the birth. Similarly, they also help to protect the individual from the sexually transmitted diseases, because they are a kind of coverings which protect and doesn't allow the transmission of the pathogens from male to female and vice versa. So this is how the condoms help in prevention of the STDs also. So this is all about reproductive health and contraceptive methods. See you all in the next video. Thank you so much.